Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today's video is going to be all about my trash. This is my beauty trash items that I have finished up during the month of November. And I'll go through it, kind of tell you a little bit what I think about it, and if I would repurchase. So anyway, so if you're new to my channel, hi, welcome. My name is Janie. I post videos on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, and I do beauty, lifestyle, and a little bit of luxury thrown in here and there for good measure. So if you would, please click onto the subscribe button. Also, you want to click on the bell notification icon so that you're notified of all future videos. So anyway, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, I don't know what happened this month, but I have a ton of trash. I don't know what happened, how I ended up with so much, but I do. So we're going to get started. So first of all, I want to talk about this item here. This is from Wee Dad. This is the Curl Quencher Moisturizing Styling Gel. This is my holy grail, ride or die, can't live without hair gel. My curls absolutely love it. It doesn't make them crunchy. It makes them very soft. It doesn't get flaky. It holds them the way that they should be held, and they like it. And I highly recommend. It's not in focus, but anyway, it's from Wee Dad. Of course, I have to have some makeup wipes in here. This is from Epple. Love these. They are comparable to the the Pond's. Anyway. I had some little bath bombs that I bought from TJ Maxx in the checkout line. And this is the Love and Hope bath bombs. That was rose hip and bergamot. These were supposed to be from Australia. There's four in the pack. It was like $7. If you see these, just bypass them. They were not good at all. Save your money. Don't waste your money on those. A Dr. Teal's wellness therapy with rosemary and mint Epsom salt soaking. This was okay. It's probably not my favorite by any means, and I will not repurchase this particular one. But there are so many other Dr. Teal ones that I absolutely love, like this one here. That is the super moisturizer avocado oil one. Oh my goodness, this will hydrate your skin like you would not believe. Word of caution though, it does make your tub a little bit slippery, so be careful. But oh, this is really good, especially this time of year when we're running our heat and our skin is getting so dried out and itchy, and that one's good. And then another product from Dr. Teal's that we tried is the Pink Himalayan Foaming Bath. This is Restore and Replenish. And this made a really, really nice bubbly bath. My husband likes to take bubble baths, and he really did enjoy this. And we'll be repurchasing that. Oh, here's the little box from those bath bombs. And they were $7.99. Don't get them. This I did not finish, but I'm getting rid of it. I'm done with it. It's from Bath & Body Shop. It's Bath & Body Works, sorry. Bath and Body Works, and it's the Wild Iris and Honey Body Scrub. This I did not care for at all. It was very hard to manipulate over the skin, and I don't even know if they even carry this anymore. I haven't purchased anything from Bath and Body Works in years. This is something I found in my stash and thought I'll put it in the shower and try and use it. No. Some vitamins. This is from Ollie, and this was the Balanced Belly. It was like a probiotic, and I really did like this. I like this brand of vitamin in general, this Ollie brand. They're gummies, so I enjoyed them and would definitely repurchase. Oh, this was a really good face cream. This is the Too Cool for School, the All-in-One Egg Mellow Cream. It's not focusing, but anyway, this can work really, really well as a day moisturizer for me. And it not only did it moisturize the skin, but also helped to prime and prep the skin for makeup. And I Too Cool for School brand is a wonderful brand. You can buy it at Sephora, and it is a Korean skincare brand. A lot of their products are really good. This right here is from Kate Somerville. It's the Exfoliate Cleanser, and it's a daily foaming wash. Very much enjoy this. This was sent to me from Optily for review. I did use all of this. I really did like this for the fact that I felt like it did leave some exfoliation to the face. There was no granules or anything like that. But what I really liked about it is it did not irritate the eyes at all. And I would definitely consider repurchasing that whenever I get through some of my more cleansers. Another product from Kate Somerville, this is the Exfoliate, and this is the Intensive Exfoliating Treatment. I did cut the little end off here so I could get all of this out. Basically, this is like a 2-minute facial on clean, damp skin. You put it on, you rub it around, and then you let it sit for a couple minutes, and you can kind of feel it tingling a little bit, and you know that's kind of like getting all that dead skin off your face, and then you add some water to it, and then you really rub it around, and you get the physical exfoliation going. It's chemical and physical, and then you rub it all around, and then rinse it off, and your face will feel as smooth as glass. I mean, it just feels so good. I would use this a couple times a week. Highly recommend. It is very expensive, though. It's the only problem with that product. A little trial size from Pharmacy. This is the Honey Potion Mask. This is one of those masks that was like a warming type mask. So you would put it onto your skin and then you would rub it around. It would kind of get milky and it would turn very warm on the skin. And it just really helped to exfoliate and to brighten the skin and to moisturize. So I do recommend that one. That one's a good one also. Here's a product from The Ordinary, and this is the Matrixyl 10% with HA that I did finish. I'm probably not going to repurchase this because I didn't really feel like I seen any type of results with it, so I'm not going to repurchase that. But The Ordinary skincare line is very affordable, and for the most part, everything's pretty well effective. This may work better for you than what it did for this little guy right here. This is something that was I received during the Sephora VIB sale in a little travel kit, and this is from Belief, and it's the Aqua Balm, the Truth Cream, or the Truth Cream, and the Aqua Balm, which is the lighter version of the moisturizer. And I really, really enjoy this during the day to use as my day moisturizer. I started using it after I was done with this Too Cool for School. And this was really nice. And what I do with this to give it a little bit more hydration for my dry, mature skin was I would add a little bit of the sea berry oil from Fresh and mix it together and put it on. Oh my gosh, it was so nice, so nice. I have another little one that I'm working on, but I think for that reason I would consider purchasing this in the full size in the Aqua Balm itself. Product from Colleen Rothschild. This is the Mandelic Acid Radiance Serum. This really does work. It's a really good acid serum to put on your face for help with exfoliation and just to make the skin nice and glowy. And I do recommend that one. Now this product here from Pure, and what this is a hydrogel lift. It was an eye. It kind of rolled up a little bit. It was a product for underneath the eye that you would put on after all of your skincare, before your concealer. You would put this on and it would kind of act as like a primer for underneath the eyes for your concealer, and it really helped with hydration. It helped with making sure that the concealer stayed smooth and didn't get all crinkly underneath the eyes. And this was a product that I enjoyed more than I thought I would. And this tube lasted a really long time because it didn't take very much at all to put underneath the eye. here's another product from The Ordinary, and this is the High Spreadability Fluid Primer. I did not like this at all. I don't recommend it. It's very silicone-y, and it really got all kind of dried up and goopy. I did not care for it at all. This little product was from Astrowoods, and it's the Argelain Serum. That it was supposed to be like a 30% Argelain, but technically it's really not 30%. It's a little bit misleading because they're considering the 30% with what they mixed it with. Anyway, if you want an Argelain Serum, get the one from The Ordinary. Because let me tell you, that one works. That one works really well. And what Argelain does is that I mainly use it here on my forehead because I have the forehead wrinkles, is that it kind of acts like Botox, and then it kind of like freezes this part right here and relaxes that area so your wrinkles are not as prominent. I mean, it's not going to take away all of your wrinkles. I mean, it's just not. But it will help to relax them and look a little bit more diminished. But like I said, get the one from The Ordinary. It works a lot better than that one did. Another product from The Ordinary, this is the Vitamin C Suspension in 25%. I did not care for this item. The vitamin C in it was good. I mean, you could feel the vitamin C working, but what I did not like was that it was, even though it's a cream, is very, very, very gritty. I mean, it's like it's got really fine particles of sand in it, but it's very gritty. And I just didn't care for that at all, so I wouldn't repurchase that for that reason. I mean, it's just like when you're rubbing it, it almost feels like you're using like fine sandpaper. And I don't know, I just didn't like that. I didn't like that feeling on my skin, and it still feels like that I've got like particles, little dust particles or something. So pass on that one. Another product from The Ordinary. I ordered a whole bunch of Ordinary products all at the same time, so I'm kind of going through them all at once. But this is the High Adherence Silicone Primer. Again, I did not care for this. I know there is a lot of people that like it. As far as the two, the other one that I showed you, I liked this one better because it was a cream. But I'm just not a big fan of silicone primers. And anyway, so I didn't recommend that one. I have an eye cream from Cosmedex. Again, this was sent to me for review. This is the Eye Genius Eye Cream. It was okay. It was not moisturizing enough for me to use at night, but I did like using it during the day, and it was just a little cream moisturizer, but didn't care for it enough to even want to try and purchase it. So here's a product from another product from Cosmedex, and this again was sent to me through Optily, and this is the Pure C Vitamin C crystals that you would add into any kind of serum or moisturizer that you like. It was okay. I like the one from Philosophy, the Vitamin C Booster, a lot better than I like this one, and I think they're about the same price. So if you're looking for a vitamin C powder that you can mix into your product, and that way you're mixing it fresh every day, try the one from Philosophy. MediSkin, I'll get it out anyway. This is the Anti-Aging Vitamin C Beauty Oil. This was purchased at either Marshall's or TJ Maxx. I don't remember which. It was okay. I just did not feel like it was that effective of a vitamin C product. It was a good oil as far as moisturizing, but as far as using it for vitamin C, no. I finished a powder from Laura Geller. This is the Balance and Brighten powder in the color Fair. I use this as a setting powder, and I really do like these, but I have so many other powders that I'm trying to work through before I repurchase that. But I finished up this little Tatcha face spray. This is the Luminous Dewy Skin Mist. This, I think, was in a kit that I bought last year during the Black Friday sales. Was it Black Friday sales or even the Sephora VIB sale? But anyway, I do like it, but it's very expensive, and I like the rose hip face mist that I get from the manufactory. I like that one better, and it's cheaper, but anyway, it's nice, and it does leave you luminous, but I just can't do it for that price. I have a little eyelash primer from Smashbox. This was the photo finish lash primer. It was okay. Just go to Walmart or your local drugstore and get the one from L'Oreal. It works just as good as any of these high brand ones, but a fraction of the cost, so just get the one from L'Oreal. Have a little mascara sample. This is the Dior Show Iconic Overcurl. It was okay. I'm not too crazy about these kind of wands that have the little curve to them. I like a straight wand with a brush where the bristles are just straight across and not curved anyway, so I didn't really care for that, but I did use. And then the last thing I have to talk about is from Murad, and this is the Rapid Resurfacing Peel. It's 10% glycolic acid. It was just a little peel pad that you just run over your face after you've cleansed, and I would assume that with continuous use of these, you could really see some clearing of the skin, because it definitely had a little bit of a bite to it. And I have put it actually onto my loves list at Sephora to purchase probably after I get through some of my other stuff that I have to get through. But I really did like that. I felt like it really was working on the skin. I lied. I have one more product, and this is from Belief, and this is the Hungarian Water Essence. And I really did enjoy this as an essence. It was very moisturizing, but it was very lightweight. If you're not familiar with what an essence is a product that you put on after your toner. And an essence will help to, because the molecules in the essence are so small, it helps to really go into the skin and kind of clear a pathway for your skincare to go in to help penetrate deeper into the skin. And this was a good one. This is also sold at Sephora. So anyway, that is it for my empties for the month of November. I hope that you have enjoyed, and will give me a big old thumbs up, and I will talk to you soon.